summer. It's a great time of year, right? Sunshine, camping, concerts, ice cream. Summer was great, but fall can be just as fabulous and meaningful at the same time. More than the colorful trees, more than the pumpkin spice everything, more than even football. It's not just about going back to school or starting a new schedule. It's about turning over a new leaf, going new places, meeting new people, getting plugged into a place where you fit in and can make a difference. This fall, your family belongs here. Your kids belong here. Your grandparents belong here. Your friends belong here. You belong here.
United Methodist Church. My name is Deb Stewart, and I will be working with Ms. Rita Gessner. If you're new to our church or just visiting, or perhaps you're looking for a new church home, if you could please take a moment and fill out these lovely blue connect cards, and we'll have someone reach out and talk to you. If there's something that's weighing heavy on your heart, or something that you'd like an extra prayer over, or perhaps something you want to lift up and celebrate, if you could please fill out one of these lovely green prayer cards. You can pass them down during the service. We will collect them and we will take a moment of prayer. And with that, it's all yours.
Good morning. As Deb said, my name is Rena Gessner. I'll be your lay reader for today. At this time, we ask anyone who has an announcement. But first, I'm going to have Maria Holzak. She has an important announcement for our church.
Thank you, Rena. Good morning, everyone. How are you? On behalf of the Staff Parish Relations Committee, I do have an announcement to make. It is my joy to share with you today that Bishop John R. Scholl has appointed Reverend Gabrielle Martone as our interim pastor of the congregation. Reverend Martone will begin her responsibilities on Sunday, September 22nd of this year. As a United Methodist Church, we are part of an appointment system. Our congregation's Staff Parish Relations Committee has met with the district superintendent to discuss the needs of our congregation and has also met with Reverend Martone to better get to know her and ask her questions. So I'm going to sit with you and watch this little brief video from Reverend Gabrielle.
Good morning, Pearl River. My name is Gabrielle Martone, and I am so excited that the bishop and the cabinet have appointed me as your interim pastor. I am so thrilled to be starting this journey with Pearl River. Some of the things that I'm so excited about being able to get to do with all of you is continuing your commitment to hands-on mission and being involved in the community. Your incredibly strong lay leadership, I look forward to coming alongside of them and continuing to figure out how we empower new leaders. I am so thrilled at the amount of time and energy that you all put into your children and your youth programs and I am deeply committed to helping those programs strengthen and grow and become a place in which we are nurturing lots and lots of young people. I have been spending the last 14 months as the Associate Pastor for Children and Youth at Central United Methodist Church in Lynnwood, New Jersey. So I have 14 months of really great experience on growing those programs. I've also served three other congregations before that as the solo pastor, and I am really excited to be able to take all of these experiences that I've had since I've been appointed to ministry and all of the gifts that God has poured into me and share them with you, and to take your gifts and the things that God has been doing in your midst for years and really be able to see all of the ways that my gifts and your gifts can come together and do some really, really incredible things. And when I move in on the 16th and the 17th of September, I will be moving in with my two cats. Their names are Ezekiel and Isaiah. There's a whole story behind that, so ask me about that when I get there. And my German Shepherd, Jasper, who happens to be a failed seeing eye reject. So he's really well trained, but probably doesn't make a very good seeing eye dog. I am so thrilled for the opportunities and the potential that God has for all of us. And I look forward to many conversations and small group studies and spirit breathing together as we start this new journey and this adventure together. So I cannot wait until the 22nd when I get to meet all of you in person. And I am so thrilled for God's hand in all of this that will really allow us to be able to do some new and incredible things. So I look forward to seeing you all soon, and I've been praying for all of you, and I cannot wait to get started. God bless. Bye.
We can continue to make disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. Bishop Scholl and the leaders of the Greater New Jersey Conference will work with us to continue to grow as a vital congregation. I know you will join the bishop and our new pastor and me in helping to make new disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. Also, if you have not gotten the circuit rider electronically, I know we still have them in paper format. There is a bio about Reverend Martone there, so if you want to know more about her background, you can read it up on. Thank you.
Thank you, and what wonderful news that is. So we're all excited and, you know, praying for good things to come to Pearl River United Methodist Church. And thank you for Staff Parish for all your hard work over the last few weeks. So I also have a few other announcements I believe people wanted to make. Yes. Helen?
Mm-hmm.
Well, welcome. Yes. Jolene? She's got a microphone. She's serious.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I just want to make sure everybody can hear me. Okay. You're going to hear a lot about the white elephant sale today. There is a clipboard going around for signups. I'm the treasurer of the UMW. We're organizing the white elephant. We have a schedule for signups. The last one we had was in 2015, but it was very successful. We made $4,800, and of that we gave $2,000 to the church. We need a lot of help for setup and the day of the sale and for cleaning up afterwards. You can call Helen D'Agostino or Joanne Lee if you have any questions. Thank you. Okay, hope to see you.
Now, do you have a list going around, a clipboard going around? Okay, okay, very good. All right, Sarah?
Good morning. I also, on the heels of that wonderful announcement from Maria, I have a sign-up sheet also because we want to get the parsonage cleaned up. Yay! So now that we have someone to go in it, we would like to, actually Val and I started on, what was that, Friday? Friday, we went over there and kind of got a sense of it. Bob went with us, and Bob took a list of what needed to be done. So I think Bob will have a list ready to go. I'm not sure when that's coming, but we're going to...
This afternoon.
Right, we're going to post it on the refrigerator inside the parsonage so that when you sign up, I have like a.m., afternoon, evening slots, whenever you can come. And, you know, if you want to just take one task, if you want to dust or sweep or whatever, I mean, it's basic. That's the basically kind of thing that we need, vacuuming, sweeping, a little dusting. And I think the trustees are probably going to do any kind of repairs. This is just cleaning. But basically... we want to check off the list, whatever you do, and if you only have an hour to work, that's fine, you know, maybe after work or in the day, whenever, but I will leave this in the coffee room, and we will have a key. I think Val has a secret place for a key, so rather than broadcasting it, I'm just going to say, once you sign up, I'm leaving our phone numbers here, and we'll tell you how to find the key. It's kind of like a game, I guess. So, but we started working on it already, and I'm just real excited about this, and I wanted to share that, and I hope that everyone will come and help us get it all done. And obviously, she said in her video that her move-in date is the 17th. That's a Tuesday, and I'm sure we're going to be heavy into planning the white elephant, too. So we got several things going on, but I just want to ask your help. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sarah. Amy, you had an announcement for education?
Yeah, we were going to have a meeting today after church. It looks like it's going to be a small and quick meeting, but it still happened. Thank you.
Okay, and also as head of church council, we're having a very brief meeting today. And next Sunday, we're having a charge conference, if you saw it in the circuit rider, and that's to officially accept the appointment of the new pastor, Gabriella Martone. All right? So... thank you, and with that said, we can now greet one another.
Thanks for your help yesterday.
Oh, no,
those shoes make you look like they're this big. Like baby shoes.
Come here.
I love them. I just noticed them. I'm like, oh.
Can you please all rise and join me in the call to worship? Make me a servant, humble and meek.
Lord, let me lift up those who are weak.
And may the prayer of my heart always be,
make me a servant, make me a servant today.
Our opening prayer. Christ beside me, Christ before me, Christ behind me, King of my heart, Christ within me, Christ below me, Christ above me, never to part. Christ on my right hand, Christ on my left hand, Christ all around me, shield in the strife. Christ in my sleeping, Christ in my setting, Christ in my rising, light of my life. Amen. Please join us in the opening hymn, I Have Decided to Follow Jesus, in the Faith We Sing, 21:29.
So today is a special day. Besides the fact that it is Sunday and it is September, it is another special day. Do any of you know what it is? It is Grandparents Day. That is Grandparents Day. Now, in my family, my grandchildren call me Nanas. Does anybody call their grandparents something other than Nana? What do you call your grandma?
Grandma.
Okay. What do you call your grandparents? Grandma. Some people say grandma, some people say nana, some people say yaya, mimi. Lots of different names for grandmothers and for grandfathers. That friend says mimi. That's right. And I think that's kind of like God, because there all over the world there are different names for God. We call God God, we call him Abba, we call him Father. We sing to him, yes we do. But nonetheless, God is God, and Grandma and Grandpa are who they are, regardless of what we call them. Now, do any of you live close to your Grandma and Grandpa?
Yeah.
Okay, you do?
Definitely.
Do any of you live far away from your Grandma and Grandpa?
No.
I do.
You do? You live far away? You don't get to see them all the time?
No.
Most of the time?
I
see
them. Okay. I and her see them every day.
And she gets to see them every day. She's very lucky.
Too.
I feel like sometimes even when we don't see our grandma and our grandpa, we know that they love them, like God loves us. We don't see him, but we know he loves us because God loves us, like our parents do, like our families do, especially our grandparents. So today, I want everyone, before we say our prayer, to blow a kiss to all parents and grandparents that are in the audience, and blow a kiss up to the grandparents that aren't with us today. Can we do that together? All right, let's do it on three, ready? One. Two, three. Now one more. Blow it that way. Ready? One, two, three.
Thank you.
All right, can we hold hands for 1 second? Thank you. Can we say, do you want to join us? All right, are you guys ready? Let's say it together. Dear God, thank you for our worldly parents and our grandparents, and for loving us and blessing us always and forever. Amen. All right. Thank you, friends. And happy Grandparents' Day to everyone.
Our Old Testament reading today comes from Jeremiah chapter 18, verses 1 through 11. The potter and the clay. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, "Come, go down to the potter's house, and there I will let you hear my words." So I went down to the potter's house, and there he was working at his wheel. The vessel he was making of clay was spoiled in the potter's hand, and he reworked it into another vessel, as seemed good to him. Then the word of the Lord came to me, "Can I not do with you, O house of Israel, just as this potter has done, says the Lord? Just like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. At one moment I may declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will pluck up and break down and destroy it. But if that nation concerning which I have spoken turns from its evil, I will change my mind about the disaster that I intend to bring on it. And at another moment I may declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will build and plant it. But if it does evil in my sight, not listening to my voice, then when I change my mind about the good that I had intended to do to it, now therefore say to the people of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, thus says the Lord, look, I am a potter shaping evil against you and devising a plan against you. Turn now, all of you, from your evil way and amend your ways and your doings."
Today's Psalm reading is Psalm 139, The Inescapable God. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down. You are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before, and you lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my unformed substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them had yet existed. How weighty to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them. I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to the end, and I am still with you. Our New Testament is the cost of discipleship. Now large crowds were traveling with him, and he turned to them and said, "Whoever comes to me and does not hate father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, and yes, even life itself, cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry the cross on and follow me cannot be my disciple. For which of you, intending to build a tower, does not first sit down and estimate the cost to see whether he has enough to complete it? Otherwise, when he has laid a foundation and is unable to finish, all will see it and begin to riddle him, saying, 'This fellow began to build and was not able to finish?' Or what king cannot go out and wage war against another king will not sit down first and consider whether he is able with 10,000 to oppose the one who comes against him with 20,000. If he cannot, then while the other is still far away, he sends a delegation and asks for terms of peace. So none of you become my disciples if you do not give up all of your possessions." God's word for us today.
Thanks be to God.
So I'm pinch hitting. Sean was supposed to preach, but they decided to go to Cape Cod. I'd rather be in Cape Cod. I'm kidding. I love it here. I love it here. Helen and I have spent a lot of time together this week. I recently was asked by a member of our church, "So where do we go from here?" Now, my response was one of silence. That's right, folks. I had a moment of silence. Y'all can laugh. I answered, We take a moment and we breathe. Breathe. We wipe the slate clean and we move on. We have been here before. Since being here at Pearl River UMC, I alone have had 5 pastors, Reverends Coauer, Ackerman, Kuhb, Stauffer, and Arlia Erickson. What I have come to realize is that the names have changed, but we are all still here. Okay, now some have left, many have come back, but we are all still here. Yesterday, I had the honor of being part of a service for James, who is the brother of Charlotte Swift, and we sent him to his final resting place. I had a chance to see her and say hello, and I realized something so unbelievably simple. Take a second to think about this. How many changes in pastors and members has Charlotte seen? For that matter, look around this sanctuary. How many pastors and members have all of you seen come and go? It's a little mind-boggling when you think about it. How many people themselves have changed churches and now find themselves here at home? How many members have we seen go, come back, go, come back? You get it, right? How many new lives have we blessed? How many members have been confirmed? How many members have been married? And yes, how many members did we honor as we sent them home to the kingdom of heaven? So here is to new beginnings. I will be honest, I don't like the unknown. I like when things go in patterns or in rhythms or even follow just simple basic rules. Now that seems probably a little strange, as being an EMT, no call is ever by a rhythm or by a pattern. But what we do by order, and we follow it. In the Old Testament, from Jeremiah 1-11, the potter, we hear that the Lord shared this: just like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you. We are formed in the likeness of God. The last line reads, turn now all of you from your evil ways and amend your ways and your doings. When we look back at the psalm, there are so many things in today's psalm reading that hit a chord with everything that this church is going through. You have known me before I was even formed. You know the very words I speak before they were even on my tongue. You lay your hands on me and you mold me. I praise you for your wonderful works as they sit here before me. And the very last line, I come to the end and I'm still anew. So here we are again, friends, facing new beginnings. Now, sisters and brothers, this is not a new beginning. It is a new chapter in the life of this church. Remember what we've heard. God has already molded us. We are just the vessels he has made to continue to be in service and mission with him. That the past be the past and a memory. Today, our new chapter and our new beginnings is full of exciting and unknown stories. I had the honor of meeting Pastor Martone, and as upbeat and as lively as you saw in that little video, that's her. Lots of energy, can't wait to be here. Now, I do not know about all of you, and I do not know what God has in store for me or my family, but what I do know is I won't fear it. I won't worry about the unknown. Let us welcome our new pastor so that we can work together to be molded into a wonderful place of stewardship, mission, and family. I could go on and on today, and I could talk about this, but I'd rather be together in song and prayer and be lifted up. Let us remember, we are all but clay. God already knows where we're going. He knows where we've been. And he knows what each and every one of us can do. He's made this family before we even knew we were a family. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, you are the potter and we are your clay. Please take us and mold us, O Lord. Hear us pray. Take our heart, O God, and make us ever true. Take our hearts, O God, and let us be like you. Please rise if you're able and join me in the hymn, Change My Heart, O God. It'll be on either on both monitors. It's also in the Faith We Sing, 2152. Does anyone have another one? Yes, David. Absolutely. All of our sick and our shut-ins. We have a card for Max Wesden, Sergeant, excuse me, Max Westman, for safe return from deployment from unknown. I get that one. A prayer for a prayer request from Ginny Hartigan. Prayers for Dawn. Okay. Dawn, Marianne, and Diane, all undergoing chemo. And for Kathy C., a friend and co-worker of Val Leonetti, who passed away last evening. A member of the congregation reached out to me last night and asked if I would please take a moment and remember 9/11, as it is this week. Dear God, we seek your grace to strengthen us as we commemorate the lives of loved ones who have been lost on this day of anguish for our country and our world. Lord, teach your children to love each other as much as they profess their love to you. We remember the courage of the countless men and women who put their lives at risk in order to rescue or just bring home all they could. Alleviate and bring solace to all of those who have been afflicted since then and those who have passed on since then. We ask this in your loving name. Amen. O Heavenly Father, we ask that you place your arms around our entire congregation and all of those mentioned here, those known only in our hearts and those that are on our prayer list. I'm going to stop for a moment. If there's anyone you would like to lift up, please feel free to.
My mom.
My mother. Charlotte Swift and the loss of her brother, James Patterson.
Everyone affected by Hurricane Dorian, especially in the Bahamas.
Your family. We know that you have molded us, and we know you have a plan for us. Give us the strength to be strong enough to get through the hard times. Give us the time to celebrate the happy times. Give us the time to slow down and enjoy life, the life that you have made for us. Give us a time to reflect on your word. Amen. Now, with the confidence that we are all the children and children of God, please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I ask now that our ushers please get ready for offertory and sit back and listen to the words of the choir. Start a new chapter in the life of this church.
Amen.
Please join me in our closing hymn. It is a cry of it is a cry of my heart. It'll be on both monitors, and it's 2165 in The Faith We Sing. Song benediction because I did the book.